Okay, this is recorded, ha? Recorded na ta. Ivan. Okay, let us start. I will share my screen. Hello. Okay, all together.
Hi.
Let us pray. Dear God, I thank you for protecting me.
Dear God, I thank you for protecting me through the night. I praise you and give you thanks for all you have bestowed
on me. Lord, I give you all my words, thoughts.
Lord, I give you all my words, thoughts, and actions, and consecrate them to you. Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing to you, for you, O Lord, are my strength and my redeemer. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Check your attendance first. So, joining today, we have Nash, Pion J, Gwyneth, Winjil Ayan, and James Anthony. 2, 4, 5. Nawa lagi si Beige Isab. Nancy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 6 pupils attended or joining this review. Okay. Okay, na, makita ra ang screen.
Naa.
Gimana yo sa tabi? Kamut-kamut ra. Naay, naay madunggan. Pion, madunggan. Madunggan?
Wa.
Wa.
Ay naa.
Ay naa, hana, hana nunggi ek.
Naa, sure.
Naay music. Okay, very good. Gimana yo sa tabi?
Naa.
Kamut-kamut sa pakita sa ko si Manaw. Oh,
Shake the tree. I got to push pineapple right.
Sugod na ta.
Review na ta. Sir, nakakita naman ko na ng agad do.
O, lagay mo sayaw. Okay, mag-share screen ko ha. Then tell me if my screen is reflected to you ha. Tingnan ko, Gwen. Kaya mo ragit ko ako sa kusog signal. Nara?
Okay.
Welcome to our review. Okay. We will have mape.
Oh, God.
Okay, number your paper 1 to 15. Yeah, number your paper 1 to 15.
1 to 5, sir.
1 to 5, music. Ready?
Yes.
Is everyone ready?
Yes.
Okay. Let's have music. So in music, I include the lessons about dynamics and tempo. Test A. Rearrange the scrambled letters in each item. Read the description for the terms. Write your answer on the space provided before each number. So, 1, 2, 3 is lessons about dynamics. Then they are scrambled. What you're going to do is to rearrange the letters to find out the word. Okay, number one. It means half.
Mezzo forte!
Oy. So what? It means half or moderately loud. Number two, it means soft. Number three, elements in music that refers to loudness or softness of sound. Done?
Yes.
Okay, let us answer. What is answer in number one?
Mezzo forte.
Hello, open your audio. Open your
mezzo forte.
Mezzo forte.
Good. The answer in number one is mezzo forte. Number two.
Piano.
Number two.
Piano.
Very good prepared. Piano.
Piano.
Number three.
Dynamics.
Number three.
Dynamics.
Dynamics. Correct. Who got 3 points? Who got perfect?
Ako.
Okay, okay, man in ha. Test one. Test A. Test A rather. Tingnan ni ako type of test. Ah, so timan ina. Pero daghan, pero dili na mao ang uban. So nanguha ra ko. I just pick you. Okay, test B, 4 and 5. Test B, 4 and 5, it's all about tempo. What you're going to do is to determine the song's tempo, if it is largo or presto. Take your answer in each row. Okay. 4, hush little baby. Baby, largo or presto? Number 5, rain, rain, go away. Largo or presto? What do you mean by largo? Largo means
fast,
slow. Largo means slow. How about presto? Presto,
moderately fast.
Very fast.
Fast.
Yeah, fast. Ayaw lagi pagbadis-badles. Ano man, babadis-badles man ay.
Di man ako.
Yeah, pati na babadis-badles ko. Okay, again, largo means slow, presto means fast. So what you are going to do is to tick. What is tick? Tick or check your answer.
Check!
So hush little baby, what do you think? Come on. Come on, hush little baby. Hush little baby. Don't say a word.
Largo.
Rain, rain, go away. Rain, rain, go away.
Presto. Ay largo.
Okay, the correct word is okay, it's okay, it's both largo. Slow songs or music. Na ako ibutang ng mga kanta, then you will determine if it is largo or presto. So adyo pa ayo pag kuan og mauning kanta ha. Basta na ako ibutang ng kanta. Nakasabot? Wala gitingog-tingog na uban.
Yes.
Sabtan ra?
Yes.
Okay, maura na. Okay, 10 items naman natong music. Okay. Imagine, kuwang naramang lima. 10 items ang music. Then art. Let's go to your art. Your art is all about paper art sculpture. So this week, you made paper bead bracelet, right? No?
They're out, sure.
You make paper bead bracelet. So, anha nga topic ko nang uha. Anha nga paper art sculpture ang dikuha nga topic. So read each of the statements below. In circle the correctly defined artwork. So what you are going to in circle. Shape outline right. In circle the correctly defined artworks. Okay. Number 6 and number 7. Number 6. It is a form of art that produces artworks in three-dimensional representation. It is considered as one of the oldest forms in the world. Sculpture, painting, sketching. Number your paper 6 to 10. Be, on sa maning number 6. Diretso na lang ta-answer para di na magbalik-balik. Ha?
Sculpture!
What is your answer?
Sculpture!
Sculpture, correct. Sculpture, correct. Number 7.
Sculpture!
At yun yung gibuhat. O to. Paper mache. Clay. Na may paper sculpture, na may clay sculpture. So, patong yun di buhat na belong to sa paper sculpture. Example ani is paper mache. O katong vase na may paper vase sculpture. Number 7. It is an example of paper
origami.
It is an example of paper folding technique. Come on.
Origami.
Origami. Very good. Origami. The answer is origami. Okay. Letter D, paper art sculpture. You have to read the following art words in each step. Cross, the word does not belong to the book. So what is cross?
Kanang EX.
Yeah, EX. Wad pun si X. Dili na lang na EX ha, kay listen sa computer. So, asay wa na belong nila imong cross. Mark cross. Okay, number 8. Additive cultural process. Subtractive cultural process. Relief printing. So, asa may nalaki nila, walay labot. Asa may walay labot nila. Number 8. Hello there. O na, maningwag. Asa naman mo?
Hi.
Asa may walay labot de? Number 8. Number 8, additive sculptural process, subtractive sculptural process, and relief printing.
Relief printing, sir! Ang wrong ka, relief printing!
Correct, relief printing. Number 9, paper mache, paper bead bracelet, origami. Paper mache, paper bead bracelet,
origami!
Asa may nalahi?
Origami.
Correct. Origami. Number 10. Old magazines, brochures, marker. Old magazines.
Marker.
Brochures, marker.
Marker.
Correct. Marker. Kanang nalahi nila, dili pareha inagamit. Wala na bilang sa topic na lesson. So, mauna ina i-cross. Dili ilahang classification. Karon, ona. Okay. That's all for art. Now let's go to your PE. Ug mapaw ko ha, same ra na link atong ganito. Sud lang mo sa link. 30 minutes ra ni? 40 under. Okay. Our PE is all about volleyball. Okay, I know that some of you send me video about how to receive and pass the volleyball and also serving the volleyball. Okay, but some of you does not submit. No, asa mo ko i-grado performance na ba? Oh, 100 points. 50 points total.
Ipas man ko.
Bahala ko ay bula. Idirag ka tong papel nga nilukot.
Ahok manggani.
Oh, availability of materials. Okay. Atong test is all about maglibot-libot para sa topic na volleyball. So, I know that familiar naman ninyo ni volleyball. Na-study kato. Kung sa ang type of passing. Naman to'y pass. Pass. Underhand pass. Overhead pass. So, number 11, it is matching type of test. Ha? Matching type. Column A match to column B. Write the answer of your answer on the answer line provided. So, number 11 has a width. Has a width of 9 meter and a length of 18 meters. 9 meters and a length of 18 meters. The center or middle line divides the court into two square halves measuring 9 meters by 9 meters. So what do you think? Kasi may dyan describe ano? Number 11.
Volleyball court.
A center or middle line divides the court. Volleyball court, correct. Yun. Letter B is the answer. Volleyball court. Correct. Number 12. It's 9 meters long and 1 meter wide. It is about 2.43 meters high for men and 2.24
meters
for women. From the ground to the top. Clue. From the ground to the top.
Volleyball net.
Volleyball net. Correct. Letter A. Volleyball net. Si Fiona lagi gating-tingog. Next, number 13. The ball does not go over the net. The ball does not go over the net. Sama na si Jack. Mula ko no, ang volleyball ko no, wala masud sa net. Sama na.
Common faults and violation.
Fault. May nabita na sila. While playing, may nabita sila. Fault. Masod. Walay score. May fault. So the answer is letter D. Number 14. This is the common type of passing. Dek, ito. Passing the volleyball. What is the very common type of passing? And
underhand pass,
receive below shoulder level. Below shoulder level.
Underhand pass.
Yeah, correct. Underhand pass. Letter C. Underhand pass. And the last number of Chile. This is also known as overhand pass. Overhand pass.
Overhead pass.
Correct. Letter E. So, technique ninyo, rondi magbalik-balik inyong answer, pwede ninyo i-crush out ang humananga letter. So, that's all for PE. So, now let's go to your health. In health, our lesson is all about first aid. Okay, nundo mo. Week 1 ra ba to? Week 1 topic. First aid. So, first aid. Naapo tay first aider. So, mahitabo ni o maay ma disgrasya mo. So, ang inyong lahat on ani is luck sa iyo pa rin. At iba na yun. Eh. So, mauni ang direction. Word hunt. Word hunt. Katong tarifa sa inyong libro. Sa book. Sa book na po nagkutaan niya. Look for the 10 words that are usually found in a first aid kit. So, unsa may makitaan ninyo sa first aid kit. Naada ni tanan. 10 na kabuok ahong
gusto. Pila man kabuok?
10 ang inyong pangitaon na po kabuok. No.
Sir, isuwat na?
No. Depende ra ninyo. Daghan ra ba ni? Daghan po da ni.
Sir,
isuwat na ho. Isuwat mo? Di ko magsaba. Patay na po kabuo. So, study about first aid. Kung sakin na sa first aid, makakita na lagi muna dan ha. O, mananaho, gibali-bali. Nice, straight. Horizontal. Ay, vertical. Thank you. Okay na?
Yes.
Hint, study ka itong nasa inyong libro. Ito nasa health na libro.
Mala!
Mala. Mala. Okay, maura to sa atong mape. So, ayaw na pagtuon o daghan. Ingat ko rin nga type of test. Basaha, kay uban, wa na hong ikuha, lahi-lahi niyo hong ikuha. So, let's go to your English. Ay, di naman mo daw. Okay, comparison of adjectives. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Fill in and complete with the correct comparison of adjectives in each row. So, nakahinom doon pa mo dito. Positive, so comparative, and superlative. Nam doon pa mo ito? Kahinom doon pa.
Gamay!
Ay, so sa'yo naman eh. Then, let's go to number one.
Magsuwat!
Adi, i-mention ra ninyo. Do not use your paper na. I-mention ra yun yung answer. Review ra man po ni. Dili man ko ay. Weekly. Weekly. Class. Okay. What is the comparative and superlative form of good? Good. Come on. Can you still remember?
Better.
Better, correct. Kinsa to na
better.
Kinsa to na cancer, isab? Correct.
Oh.
Correct. Then superlative form of good is?
Better, best.
Correct.
Best.
Best. Good, better, best. Tamao na. So, kumplito na. Number two. The given form of verb is superlative in form, which is strongest. So, let us fill in the
strong
comparative form. Strong.
Strong.
No, that's my comparative form.
Stronger.
Stronger. Correct.
Stronger.
Stronger. Correct. Correct. Yon. So, naon to, ha? Di dai masarok. Okay, number three. The given form of word is comparative in form, which is lazier. So let us fill in
lazy.
Positive and super
lazy.
Sunod. Superlative.
Laziest.
Laziest. Sayon lesson.
Laziest.
Sayon lesson.
Sayon.
Sayon. Sayon.
Sayon.
Dictionary ni grade 1. Dahil na grade 1. Pero dahil ko gihatag word. Dahil ko gihatag word. Nga na. Nga na ang test. Test B. Recognizing adverbs. Test B. Recognizing adverbs. Identify the underlying adverb. It is time, place, manner, frequency, and degree. So, ang say answer? Time, place, manner, frequency, and degree. Okay, anha mo mutan ang sa underline words or adverbs. Okay, number 4 to 8. Okay, let's start with number 4. The boys heard a shrill whistle a few minutes later. Underline words are a few minutes later. Sama na time, place, manner, frequency, degree.
Time.
Very good.
Time.
Very good, Isab. Time. Answer. Number 5.
Time.
Number 5. outside, outside the tent, the translator was ready. Place, very good.
Place. Manner.
Place, very good. Poo-poo bark loudly. The underlined word manner. Is
manner.
Manner, correct. Manner, ang answer. Manner. Number 7.
Frequency.
Always. Always. Kalingaw. Always.
Frequency.
Frequency. Very good. Frequency. Very good. It's frequency. Kapilaman. Kanunay. Okay, number 8. The cave was very dark. The underlying adverb is very.
Degree.
Very.
Degree.
Correct.
Degree.
Correct. Degree. So that's how will you answer in recognizing adverbs. So naman tayo, adverbs of time, adverbs of place, adverbs of manner, adverbs of frequency, and adverbs of degree. So let's go to figurative language. So maglibo graba mo dani no? Ikalima ni onomatopeya ha. Apil ang onomatopeya.
Kaya nagtuon ko ana.
Very good, kaya nagtuon. So 9 to 13. 9 to 13 is all about figurative language. So we have 5. We introduce to you the 5 figurative language. Simile, metaphor, hyperbole, personification, and onomatopoeia. When you say simile, simile uses as and like. Oh, manahin ng dumi ha? Simile uses as and like. Nani now?
Yes.
While metaphor is the direct comparison. Ang saang metaphor? Direct comparison.
Direct comparison.
Sinasadya mo gamit kong as. Sinasadya mo gamit kong like. Diritso ra. Ba, palagi ka. Na, metaphor. Hyperbole. Hyperbole. Katong mga palabaw ba? Palabaw. Katong example is The river, the river was gushing out of red fluid. Oh, red fluid. So, nakakit na ba mo red river? Nagpaka na ba? Red blood river. So, hyperbole na. Isa pa ba example sa hyperbole? Kana mga palabaw, bitaw, iniwad. Hyperbole. Next is personification. So, mauni siya ka to. Mag-compare ta sa non-living. Mag-compare ta sa non-living into living. Non-living thing siya, then inisigang i-compare sa living things. For example, the flowers dance gracefully. The flowers dance gracefully. So dance kay usama na siya sa characteristic sa tao, di ba? O mana personification, non-living thing i-compare nato sa characteristic of a person. So, manay mo, unsa may mga karakteristik sa person. Mukhaon, eating, dance, sing, laugh. O, kung kanang mga mahimo sa mga tao, then imo na igamit yung sentence. So, manay, personification siya. Onomatopeya, mauna ang sounds of nature. Mga tahay, the water flops water plops. So, mga sounds na siya ng onomatopoeia. Kani, buzz, buzz. Ang sama na, sound sa B. Mga nature sounds or insect sounds. So, mga na mga onomatopoeia. So, dali ra na ma-enhance sa sentence. So, let us start with number 9. Lahapit alas 2 to 30 at tama. The alien's skin was as white as paper. What is your answer? Encircle the word.
Simile! Simile!
Correct. Simile. Simile. Correct. Simile. Next. The alien's hair was like metallic copper.
Simile. Simile. Simile.
Simile. Kaya nga naman na ay word nga like.
Ay, gi-compare man si Jachar na gamit og like.
Like, the karinay as. Okay. Kani, the transporter buzzed to life. The transporter
buzzed. Onomatopoeia.
Onomatopoeia.
Correct. Charot, umauna sila. Onomatopoeia. Oh. Sunod. The transporter danced widely on the rug terrain.
Onomatopoeia.
Isa mo ng word na dance. The transporter danced.
Personification. Personification.
Personification. Personification. Okay, next. Number 13. The leak was gushing out a river of red blood.
Hyperbole. Hyperbole. Hyperbole.
Hyperbole palabaw. Kaya ang river kuno na puno sa red blood fluid na dugo kung mag-water sa river. So, mauto sa figurative language. So, let us go to silent letters. So, your teacher will read the following words. Box the consonant in the following words that is or are silent letters. So, naay uban na word na duha ang silent letters. Na po yung ban is sara. So, imong i-box.
I-box ang silent chair.
Yeah, ang naka-silent ni Dia, kanang inagbasa, di ma-appel. Pero naasya. Muragot ni Dia, nga naanga muragwa. Okay. Number 14, calm. Calm.
L.
L, correct. Calm.
L, ang silent word.
Oh, L, ang silent word. Correct. Isa, sa atong large. Number 15, listen. Listen.
T. T, letter T. Letter T.
Ala, ay ban, the drawing. Bantay ka ron. Listen, letter T.
T.
Letter T, correct. Number 16, doubt. Doubt.
And doubt.
Doubt.
B, 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 B.
So that
B.
Word.
B, B, B.
Okay. So your English exam is 40 items. 40 items ha. So daghan ko. Manakot. So, daghan ko kuan words na gibutang ani. Then, your teacher will be the one to read the word. So, listen. Listen ra mo. Listen ra mo.
Sir, on sa next subject.
Next subject is science. Palihog. Wad asa ng drawing. Okay. Seryoso ni. Seryoso. Seryoso taron. Okay, science. Let's go to your science subject. Pinapay Filipino. Okay, do you remember a lesson about electromagnetism and series and parallel circuits?
Magnetic!
Oh, read, raha, read. Ayaw sa guha. So, the type of test gihapon is scrambled letters. I give the definition and you will give the right word. So, read the description for the terms. Write your answer in the space provided before each number. Number 1, the ability of a material to attract certain metals result from the motions of electrons in an atom. Sama na siya, kani. Kana, unsa man na. Number one, attract metals.
Electromagnetism.
Kana mo pilit. Mo attract. Magnetism, correct. Magnetism. Number two is a cylindrical coil of wire in which a magnetic field is generated by passing a current through it.
Solenoid! Solenoid!
Solenoid. Very good, Gwen. Solenoid. Solenoid. Number three means magnetism is removed. Diwa ang magnetism.
Demagnetize.
Correct. Demagnetize. Demagnetize. Correct. So, maoran na. 10 items na. So, let us be. Series and parallel circuit. So, asa man ana?
Teacher!
Mabutan ko
teacher! Ako, teacher! Ako!
Basta, mabutan ko lesson. Be, kaning kinaunhang picture mo ni si letter A. Kaning kaduhang picture mo ni si letter B. Asa man ana ang series circuit? Series. Katong musigatanan kayo.
Kinaunhang teacher! Kaya namaon sa jay ka na... Naman si Jay ka na bitong imo bitong si Jay switch napud si switch
oo panguni mo switch ma off sila tanan dili
oh
ma off tanan dili
ma off
very good characteristic of series circuit you turn on the light all lights will light up then you turn off, mapang po silang tanan. So that is the characteristic of series circuit. So what we have, may identify sa ni, kung sa may naasa, electrical path. Sa may, battery cell, battery or cell, switch and
battery
or cell.
Sunod. Boom, battery teacher.
Sunod.
Sunod.
Switch of device load or the light bulb. Mama na. Then, kani ikaduha nga picture. Unsa man ni siya? Kani ikaduha? Unsa man ikaduha nga picture?
Series. Parallel.
Unsa may characteristic sa parallel circuit? Unsa man toy characteristic sa parallel circuit? You can remember the lesson. Page isa. Nash, be Nash. Unsa may characteristic sa parallel circuit? So, lahi-lahi sila og load. Lahi-lahi sila device load. So, ina-turn on sa switch og isa ra ka suga ang on. So, magtagsa na sila og switch. Just like what we use in our houses, diba? Lahi-lahi ag suga lahig switch ang atong kwarto, lahig switch ang sala, lahig switch ang CR. So, maon na example sa parallel circuit. Next, we have withering of rocks. Withering of rocks, di ba na atay? Mechanical, biological, mechanical, chemical, and biological weathering. So, nga naman ang mga rocks, ang mga rocks na ay gagmay, na ay dako, na ay nabuak. It's
because of weathering.
Because of weathering. And we have three. Mechanical, chemical, and biological. So, number six, seven, and eight. Let us answer. Number six. Which best describes the process of weathering? Ito man din. The process of weathering.
B! B!
Letter B? To L.
Yeah.
A, it is a natural transport of oil from one location to another.
Letter A!
It is the process of building up sediments to form larger rock formations. So larger, panarabang mga dagpong nga batong, mga banay weathering. C, it is the breaking of
sure.
due to human activity such as mining and farming. So, mining or farming raba ang makabreak sa mga dato. Or letter D, it is the natural process of breaking down rocks to smaller fragments when exposed to
It is a natural transport of soil from one location to another.
No, soil di ay. Rocks, withering of rocks. Asa man ana? Best describe. Letter D.
Teacher.
Letter D. It is the natural process of breaking down of rocks.
So,
for example, ha situation na breaking down of rocks into smaller fragments. Example in mechanical, kanang wave, through water, kanang waves, kusog ang bawag,
mabito
ito ng ay mga bato sa dagat, ay mahimo, mahimo lagi ni siyang cave, dami, tao da ay gadukbukbukbuk ba na, di man, tubig man, nagbanda-banda sa tubig, na kurma siya, muragad na cave, malaw. Next. Which of the following processes involves the breaking down of rocks without changing their chemical composition? Without changing
mechanical
weathering, correct. Mechanical weathering. Next, number eight. Which of the following processes involves the breaking down of rocks by chemically changing their position? Oh, chemically changing. Chemical weathering. So, na ay hinto, na ay context clue. Taro nga, basa. Maka-answer. So, letter D. Weathering of rocks, gihapon nga topic. Then, you will classify the given pictures. Sa manisida, number 9. Unsa man nga klase sa weathering na sa kuan man sa desert tungod sa kainit sa desert to niya tungod sa kainit nabuak ang bato sa mga chemical, mechanical, biological.
Mechanical.
That's your answer again.
Mechanical,
correct. The answer is mechanical weathering. Kato, ang makapabuak sa bato tungod sa mechanical weathering, sa to, heat, water, air. So, mauna, sa environment na air, water, heat. sa kainit. Sa kainit sa panahon. Init na to have the shirt, di ba? Say, number 10, unsa man ni siya? Na gilumot, nailumot ang bato, gilumot.
Ako, teacher, ako. So, biological.
Isa meron.
Biological.
Correct.
Ako, Gwen. Biological.
Biological, correct. Biological, kay naay ni pilit nga plant. Tungod sa naay ni pilit nga plant, ang bato nalahi na pagkon.
Teacher, kay biological.
Number 11. Oh, naay ni
biological.
Naay ni turok nga tanom sa tunga sa bato. Naay ni turok nga tanom sa tunga sa bato.
Biological.
Biological. Correct. Biological. Kusa ning oko. Biological. Okay, weather disturbances. Let's go to weather disturbances. So we have typhoon, tropical storm, severe tropical storm, super typhoon, and tropical depression. So what we are going to do is to arrange. I-arrange na nimo. Asa may mauna? Asa dahil hinay? Gikan sa hinay hangtod sa kusog. According to its wind strength or wind speed. I-arrange na nimo ha. So that is your clue. Ari, ari ka mag-arrange, ari. Okay, unsa may mauna? Ana, lima. We have five. Classification of typhoon. So, unsa may pinakahinay, ana nila? Gikan man kuno sa hinay ang
tropical depression.
So, may una.
Tropical depression.
Correct.
Tropical depression.
Sunod. Sunod.
Typhoon ay tropical storm.
Tropical storm. Correct.
Tropical storm.
Sunod.
Typhoon.
Typhoon.
Typhoon. Severe.
Severe.
Severe tropical storm. Severe tropical storm.
Sunod.
Last kay super typhoon.
Napay kaupat.
Ay, pwede ay. What's that, chair?
Ang ikaupat, babe.
Juan, teacher, ang ikaupat, chair, kay typhoon.
Typhoon. Sunod. Wala kita mapaw.
Severe. Super typhoon. Katong tropical. Katong super tropical. Super typhoon.
Kinakusgan si super typhoon. So, magsunod rin na sila si typhoon. So, the last is weather disturbances. Ang sa to, bagyo is also known as cyclone. Sa other country, cyclone ang tawag. Ito ang typhoon, bagyo. So, identify whether the changes observed the occurrence of a cyclone or bagyo is before, during, or after. So, na kung gihatag ng mga situation. Kung gihatag ng situation, identify ninyo o nahitabo na before.
Ang number 17, I am.
Bota ko naman. Identify ninyo before a typhoon, during a typhoon, and after the typhoon. So, the high clouds in the sky. High clouds in the sky before, during, after.
Before! Before!
Before.
Correct, before. Sunod. Dry and cold.
Before!
Dry and cold.
Before!
Before food.
Before!
Before. Sunod. Number 19. Missing person. Nangawag mga tao.
After.
During.
After.
After. During.
After. Uy.
After.
During.
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 Mangita de ka.
During.
During. Sir, ang 20 after.
During. During. During.
During.
During.
During.
During. During. During.
Ivan, punta nga sa nawa. During or after. Pwede na siya. Destroyed properties. Pwede sa ipalid imong atop. Pagkamulong bagyo. pagkahuman na tumpag imong bay. So maura to. Maura to sa science. Let's go to Filipino. Awa na tayo time. Ala, nawa. Magatong Filipino. Ari tabi. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
1, 2, 3.
Nawa, agahong kuha nga picture. Nawa. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hindi na ka.
Nana.
Dumaling ka lang yun
ah. Nana. Imbukan.
Sa, ngita ko ha. Nawaon. Nawa, man, honey, ba na? Karejo. Okay, na to sa last subject, ha? So na ako gihatag na Dewey Decimal System. Dewey Decimal System in Tagalog for in Filipino for in Tagalog ni siya. Pareho ra gyud sa English Tagalog na ramo gihatag sa English. So na tay 000099 general reference. 100 to 199 filosofiya at teologiya. 200 to 299 religion. 300 to 399 agham panlipunan. 400 to 499 wika. 500 to 599 agham at matematika. 600 to 699 teknolohiya. 700 to 799 sini. 800 to 899 pamitikan at historika. 900 to 999 geografiya at kasaysayan. So naasin tayo mga gipanghatag na dictionary at encyclopedia kaya gano'n kita pa. So anharam mo na ang mong guide as a written out. Kung sa inyo answer, kaning number. Kaning number one, kalagayang pangkabuhayan ng Pilipinas. Kalagayang pangkabuhayan ng Pilipinas. Ang kabuhayan, ekonomiya, economics. Asa man na nabilong? Hello.
Ang number one teacher kay 300 to 399.
Correct, 300 to 399. Economic. Medicina, medicine.
Asa man na? Ang number 2 teacher kay 500 to 599.
Okay, agham, science. Agham, agham, matematika. 500 to 599. Tula, haiko, tugma. Tula, haiko, tugma.
Ang number 3, sir, kay 800 to 899.
Very good, panitikan. It's panitikan. 800. Kanang, sige, tula, tula, tula.
4, sir, kay kuan. 900 to 999.
Kapito. Very good. Buhay ni Agapito Flores. O katong naghisgot ka, o laing tao, imong idol siya. Talang buhay.
900 to 999. Last number, chair, 800. To 899.
Oh,
800 to 899.
800-899. So, are na punta. Parirala, sugnay at pangungusap. So, ang imong isuwat dan ni parirala, sugnay o pangungusap. Kaya sa itong pangungusap, na ay si Muno, na po si Jay Panaguri. Complete thought siya na ay bantas. So, na bantas. Ay tuldok, na ay padamdam, smart, o na yung mga marka sa kilihan. O na yung pangungusap. Complete siya. Dili si Jahangin na nasa. Ang parirala, mato'y walang kabuhay-buhay. Independent, dependent clause. May tawag mo sa dependent clause. Okay?
Hindi man kompleto.
Hindi siya kompleto. Kung ano siya, panaguri na siya tanan or simuno na siya tanan. Why sumpay ba? Why sumpay? Hindi ito. Hindi ito gumagamit. Okay. Okay. Ang sugnay, ang sadayuhanan ng sugnay kapag ito ay ginagamitan ng
Kuwanser, ang sugnay
ginagamitan ng pangatnig. O, diba sa English, itong mga conjunction, diba? Pamantong and, or, because. Ito'y conjunction sa English. Sa Tagalog, ito ay tinatawag na pangatnig. So, ang mga pangatnig sa Tagalog, ito ay ang kapag, kaya, muna, sapagkat, muna. Muna, tinailhan, o sugnay yung answer na ay mga kaya, kapag, at iba pa. Then, ito ilailangon, number six. Kapag nagsikap ang leader, kapag nagsikap ang leader, parirala, sugnay, pangusap.
Sugnay, teacher! Sugnay! Sugnay!
Correct, sugnay. Okay, number seven. Kayamanang maituturing ng isang pinuno ang kanyang nasasakupan. Kayamanang maituturing ng isang pinuno ang kanyang nasasakupan. Toldok. Toldok. May toldok. Pangungusap. Kailhanan lagi. Pangungusap. Number eight. Mabuting katangian.
Parirala.
Correct. Parirala. Parirala. Number nine. Niyanig ng
lamig.
Niyanig ng
lamig. Parirala.
Correct. Parirala. Number. Wala.
Sugnay. Ang last year kay Sugnay. Sugnay. Sugnay.
Number 10. What is your answer? Kaya na mapili ang kapayapaan. Ay pangatnig.
Sugnay! Sugnay!
Sugnay!
Correct. Sugnay!
Sugnay. Sugnay. O, oh, arita sa sugnay. Sa ang sugnay?
Nice on me.
Sugnay ay close. Close sa English. So, naatay.
Mane, ito mamagal, eh?
Sugnay na makapag-iisa at sugnay na makapag-iisa. So, sugnay na makapag-iisa o tinatawag na pangungusap. Anong pangungusap na sila? Kay na si Jan. If complete na ay bandas, ay simon na ang panaguri. So, ang sugnay na di makapag-iisa, di siya pa, di siya pa, stand alone. Mana SDM. So, atong basahon ang mga halimbawa. Then, we are going to encircle. Bilugan natin ang tama.
Kutcher!
Okay, number one. Ang positibong pananaw ay magandang halimbawa.
M! SM.
Correct. Isa itong pangungusap, completor. Ang positibong pananaw ay magandang halimbawa. Number 12. Dahil nagbibigay ito ng inspirasyon sa kabataan. So ang ilhanan day og
SDM.
Og SDM day ay katungmugamit sa daog pangatli.
SDM.
So mura ra po nig sugnay.
SDM.
Sugnay ang SDM.
SDM.
Correct. SDM.
SDM.
Number 30. Kasi ay lakas na
SDM.
Harap. Kasi ay lakas loob na
DM.
Subo. Correct. SDM. Correct. Number 40. Aalis ito ng pangamba o takot. Nakapag-aalis ito ng pangamba
o takot. SM.
Okay.
SM.
SM. Correct. Isa itong pangungusap dahil ito ay may sinuno at panaguri. Naas dagil gamit
ang SM. SM.
Ang paghanap ng buhay ay nagiging magaan. SM.
SM.
Correct. SM. Correct. So, nasayop ko og hatag sa pointer sa Filipino. Aglas kay ang gihatag kay simuno at panaguri. So, wa man day na naho giapil no. Wa na naho giapil na lesson. Diretso ta sa aralin 3 which is all about mga uri ng pangungusap ayon sa gamit. So, ang inyong ay i-identify ani kung ito ay pasalaysay, patanong, padamdam, at pautos. O katong nag-ingon og pasalaysay, katong nag-istorya ra ka, nihatag ra ka sa information, mao na'y pasalaysay. Patanong is nagtanak ka. Ilhanan sa patanong na ay question mark. Ang pasalaysay di ay tuldo. Ang patanong, question mark. Ang damdam, nasupo ka, nalipay ka, or nahadlok ka. So, mao na'y panamdam. Ginagamitan ito ng adam. Exclamation point. At pautos. Pangungusap na uutos. Ginagamitan ito ng bantas na toldo. Ginagamitan ito na bantas na toldo. Be number 16, be maka-identify ba mo? E-X na tong simuno at panaguri ha, wala to'y labot. Hatong gialis dan sa mga uri ng pangungusap ayon sa gamit. Number 16, pakitulungan ninyo ako rito. Pakitulungan ninyo ako rito. Pasalaysay, patanong,
pautos. Pautos.
Pautos. Correct.
Pautos.
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 17 kay padamta.
Number 17. Yehey! Nauna ako sa
padamta.
Padamdam. Correct.
Padamdam.
Correct.
Padamdam.
Nagsisikap ako sa pag-aaral. Nagsisikap ako sa
pasalaysay.
Pasalaysay. Correct. Pasalaysay.
Pasalaysay.
Yeah, pasalaysay is the correct answer. Nais naming magtagumpay sa buhay.
Pasalaysay.
Helicopter. Helicopter.
Pasalaysay.
Helicopter. Ito ray.
Nganong na may helicopter na iban?
Helicopter.
Nganong man na adya si Duterte? Number 21.
Amo puncher nila, bay!
Wow, nanalo si Gulcuminis.
Padamdam!
Charot, kinsa maroon isinggit? Padamdam!
Aminong lang doho, guhin ito isab.
Very good.
So tawalog ito.
Okay, so that's all. Ang mga naminaw, maka-answer ka dito inagkahuibis. No, 10 minutes left.
I will. Daghan akong naka-teacher.
We'll join to grade 4 na. So, ako na i-stop share ha.
Okay.
May I see you? Turn on your video. Turn on.
Hiya.
Hara mag-helicopter, Ivan. Aso, helicopter ni mo. Ano man imong buhok ay ban? Gapabang, sumpa. So,
aman.
Is aman mo mo aris iskilahan.
Opo.
Isang adlaw.
Ni kahoy bis.
Kahoy bis. Okay lang may.
Kahoy bis.
Pwede ra mo ibilin. Pwede ra po mo kuhaon inang paniud to. Sa mga di magbawon. Pwede ra mo ulit man. Pwede mo uli. Down sa layo. Si EJ magbaw ni kalayo man. So nakasabot ra mo sa atong review?
Yes.
So, karon ha, ako yung base, pero mo bawi pa ulit sa dinan. So man EJ ha? Wow, ina na ayan ha. Bahalag mag-collab mo ni Istab. Sa mga parang saba at ready ko pa doon. So that's all for the review. So let us pray before we adjourn our meeting. I will share my screen then. Ayan, huwibis to Ariana. Di maglimot-limot.
Oh, lagi-lagi. Buntag, Char.
Buntag. Full day.
Alas
day. Full day ta. Di og tagalagyo. Pwede ra magbaon. Agkuhaon.
Di pwede.
Di balik na po ta launa.
Sa nang may sundo.
Pwede ra po ta. Balik na po ta launa.
Ayan, kita doon. Bilin po kasi yung mama, ha? Bilin po ka, ha? Oh, monhin na rin kwento, ha?
Okay, mabasa. Is my screen reflecting?
Yes!
Okay, let us pray all together. The Lord is my...
Psalm 23:1-5. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me to lie down. He leads me beside in still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness. For his name's sake, yet though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. You rod your staff before me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemy. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Amen.
Okay. Turn on your video back.
Where is it?
Screenshot ko. Turn on your video. Hi, James Anthony. What? Mas kay ba? Nah. Okay. Thank you for joining. You can leave now. Pwede na mo mo leave.
Yay!
Yeah.
Let me know what's up.